If software development and software engineering is so in demand, why is it so hard to land a job? Hey friends, welcome back to my channel. Today, I'm going to be answering that question. As someone who is a software developer and has been both the interviewer and interviewee, I'm really going to go into why is it so difficult to get a job if you've gone to school for computer science or self-taught yourself or even went to a coding boot camp. Different scenarios face different issues, but I really want to talk about today about why it is so difficult, or it seems so difficult, to land a job as a software developer or software engineer. You see over and over again from news articles to different blog posts how in demand software development and software engineering is. In the same breath, you also seem to hear from different people in the industry how difficult it was to land, especially their first job. And it's really hard to understand how can both statements be so true. It's difficult to land a job, but yet there's so much demand for these roles. What's going on here? Today I want to really break it down for you as to what I'm thinking anyways is the reason behind this. Before we get into it though, I want to share with you a statistic to share with you really how rapidly and further in demand these roles are becoming. Over the next 10 years, BLS estimates the US labor market will add 316,000 software developer jobs, which is a phenomenal 22% growth rate, or an average of about 31,000 new jobs each year. This statistic is mind-blowing. There are very, very few and far between jobs that are growing at that rate of 22% for demand. It's crazy. So then comes the question, well, why is it so hard to get a job as a software developer or software engineer? One of the main reasons I think it can be difficult for a software developer or engineer to land a first job is because software itself is so broad, and companies are looking typically for a very specific skill set to fill a need. So if you are someone who's applying to front-end developer roles, but you find most companies currently are looking for back-end developers, there's your issue number one. A lot of times companies won't completely do a 180 and hire someone who doesn't have any experience in what they're looking for, but has experience in other areas. Now, this isn't always the case, but typically they will hold out and wait to find someone who is more along the lines of what they are looking for. And while some companies will be willing to invest in the individual, train them on their technologies, and really see the benefit of hiring someone that maybe is more junior or doesn't have any experience with the technologies they are being used, the benefit meaning that they will be able to be trained in a way that they don't come in with any bad habits. They're able to learn how to structure the code, use the technology in the way that works best for the company. Another reason I really think it can be hard to land a software developer or software engineering role is because technical interviews are kind of a game in their own way. And what I mean by that is technical interviews are structured in a way that the company is hoping to find the best candidate possible. However, there are so many flaws in technical interviews, and when people are doing technical interviews, even the best of the best can stumble and get nervous. And if you are even a really amazing programmer, you can fail at technical interviews. The technical interview process has gotten a lot better and companies are starting to realize this, but it definitely has a long way to go. Regardless if you like technical interviews or don't, I think one thing we can all agree on to a certain degree is the tests or the problems you are solving during a technical interview are not what you will be doing in real world scenarios. It's more so to show your way of thinking. Do you have logical skills, communication skills? But some companies take this so literally, and rather than looking for the important things like that, they're looking for, can you solve this problem? And if you can, you're great. If you can't, I don't know. And those companies, unfortunately, even though they are few and far between, they do exist. Another issue I see, especially with technical interviews, is a lot of times when you are doing a coding interview specifically, you'll be able to code in whatever language you are comfortable with, which is great, that's a bonus, but if the interviewer themselves are not familiar with that language, they are a technical person but not familiar with the language, it can kind of put a barrier between you and the interviewer, and maybe they will naturally gravitate towards someone who is coding in a language that they are familiar with. Another reason I think it can be so hard to land your job, or your first job anyways, as a software developer or software engineer is the interview process is grueling. There are typically at least three different interview steps or different interviews to land a job, and throughout these different interviews, you are talking to so many people that Your resume can get kind of lost between the cracks, or even if you are the best candidate, sometimes this can go missed. A lot of times too, if you are applying to a company and there are other applicants who maybe have some ties within the company, that can sometimes cause some gray areas as well. And if the other candidates are referred, I mean, a lot of times companies will go with referrals because they know that if it's referred by a great employee, they're hoping that this referral will be great as well. So I think the real question here is not so much as to why is it so hard to get your first job or a job as a software developer or engineer, but the real question is how do we fix the interview process, the technical interview process that seems to be causing so many people to fall through the cracks? And that is a question that is so big and so vast, I don't even know where to begin with that. And there are so many layers to it. But I think one thing that we can do as software developers or software engineers, especially when you are looking for a job and finding it difficult, is honestly stick with it and take the feedback that's coming your way. But if you're not really getting any feedback, maybe even ask the interviewer, why did you go with someone else, or what, you know, why did we not connect, or why didn't you choose me? Don't actually say why didn't you choose me, but more so or less have an understanding as to why they went with someone else. And a lot of times having that understanding and communicating with the interviewer for feedback, it will tell you if it's actually something that you need to improve on, or if it is just the process and for various reasons they went with someone else. I remember when I was looking for my first job as a software developer, I think I applied to, I was doing like 10 companies a day or something crazy like that. It took a long time, especially if you don't have any prior experience, to find a company who is willing to take a chance on you, especially as a junior. It's not impossible. I'm speaking firsthand. It will happen, but you have to be persistent. And also recognize that the process for interviewing and applying to so many companies is completely normal. You're going to have to apply to a lot of companies. Typically, maybe you'll get lucky before you land that first job. Oftentimes, once you land your first job though, there is like a switch that goes off and all of a sudden recruiters will be hitting you up, asking you to come work for their company and so much more. So do not lose faith. You really just have to go through this process of having the difficulty of landing a software developer or software engineering job, usually just at the beginning of your career. That being said, it does happen throughout your career for many people for various reasons, but right now the market is needing so many more developers and engineers, but not just any, really good quality ones. And that's key to note as well. Companies aren't just looking to hire developers to code. They want good developers. They want developers that can code in the best way possible, communicate, be team players, and so much more. I hope this gives you some further insight as to why it is so hard to land a job as a software developer or software engineer if there is so many roles in demand, or these roles are so in demand. The reality is it's just a process and you have to be part of that process, and you're going to fall through the cracks sometimes, and other times you are going to get picked up by these amazing companies. Thank you all for watching my video. I hope this was valuable for anyone who is going through the interview process or had this question before as to why is it so difficult. Leave in the comments other questions you have or other video topics you want me to cover, and I will see you all soon. Make sure though to hit that subscribe button for more tech and coding related videos. Give this video a thumbs up, and bye everyone.